In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We'll be celebrating the wonderful Mass in honor of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned.
You don't hold this as much back.
Okay. My fault, my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who prepared a fit dwelling place for the Holy Spirit, in the heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary, graciously grant that through her intercession we may be a worthy temple of your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but, following their own desires and insatiable curiosity, will accumulate teachers and will stop listening to the truth and will be diverted to myths. But you, be self-possessed in all circumstances. Put up with hardship. Perform the work of an evangelist. Fulfill your ministry. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, I will sing of your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
My mouth shall be filled with your praise, with your glory day by day. Cast me not off in my old age. As my strength fell, forsake me not.
I will sing of your salvation.
That I will always hope and praise you evermore and more. My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will treat of the mighty works of the Lord. O God, I will tell of your singular justice. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing of your salvation.
So will I give you thanks with music on the lyre, for your righteousness, O my God. I will sing your praises with the harp, O Holy One of Israel.
I will sing of your salvation.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia.
Blessed is the Virgin Mary who kept the word of God and pondered it in her heart.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Read from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Each year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went up according to festival custom. After they had completed his days, as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem. But his parents did not know it. Thinking that he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances. But not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. All who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. The Gospel of the Lord. I feel very honored and privileged to be able to concelebrate with these wonderful priests that are with me. And I feel honored to be able to celebrate the Mass with you on the day after the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, when we celebrate the Immaculate Heart of Mary. So in this Mass, we all have our own intentions. So I've got two intentions. The first intention will be I'll be praying for all these priests, my brother priests, that they would experience the love of the Heart of Mary, and that these priests will show you the great love of the Heart of Jesus and Mary. So that'll be my first intention, praying for my brother priests. My second intention will be I'm going to be praying for all you people, that you'll experience the great love that comes from the heart of Jesus and Mary, and that you'll be able to give that love to others, because we can't give what we don't have. So that's my intention for my brother priest, as well as for all of you, that we'll experience the love of God and be able to give it. So that's my intention in the Mass. And my homily will be based on just a few words that were said in 1531 by Our Lady Guadalupe to Juan Diego. So I'd just like to take a few of those words and see how the heart of Mary is speaking through these wonderful words. All of you know that Our Lady Guadalupe appeared to Juan Diego in 1531 four times, and December 12, 1531, we have the great miracle of the roses. But the conversation between Juan Diego and Our Lady is, we just see the heart of Mary. And invite you, maybe just go Google in the words of Mary to Juan Diego. They're among the most endearing words of all the apparitions. And what does she say? She says, "No te aflijas, no soy yo tu madre," in Spanish, which is, "Do not be afflicted, don't worry. Am I not your mother?" Beautiful words. How many mothers here? A lot. I know about the fathers here, but one of my favorite words on Mary is from St. Augustine. St. Augustine said this: if we could put all the love of all the mothers of all time, of all places together, the love that Mary has for you individually is much greater. If you're ever in consolation, that'll give you a lot of joy. I repeat, this is the great St. Augustine, one of the greatest teachers in the Catholic Church. Put all the love of all the mothers, of all times, of all cultures together. The love that Mary has is greater than that for you, and for you, and for you, and for you, and for me. Isn't that consoling? And that's not hyperbole. I mean, St. Augustine is telling us the truth. So remember, then you mothers, and you love your children, right? Even on the tough days, you would be willing to die for your children, right? I believe it. So if that's the case, the love of Mary is greater than all the mothers of all times, no? And it's not hyperbole, it's the truth. So once we're aware of this great love of Mary's love for us, then we can give that love to others. So pray that you'll be convinced of this great love of Mary for you. Okay? She says, don't be afraid, I'm your mother. Then she says, estás en el cruzar de mis brazos. She says, en el cruzar. She's in the crossing of my arms. You know what she's really saying? You are in my heart. Yes? Because behind the crossing of her arms is her heart. So all of you today are in the Immaculate Heart of Mary. The world is tough. I want two refuges. I want to find refuge in the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. I know about you. My two refuges, the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. So you're in Mary's heart. Then she says, estás en mi sombra. Sombra in Spanish is, you're in my shadow. No matter where you go, your shadow follows you. I see this related to the song Santa Maria del Camino. Now, Santa Maria del Camino in Spanish is Our Lady of the Way. No matter where you go, Mary is accompanying you. Remember when I was a child, I loved sports, and I would try to race my shadow. And I would try to race my shadow, say, ready, set, go. And every time I tried to race, my shadow always beat me. And after trying it 10 times, I got tired, and they said, okay, you'll win. So Mary's with us. No matter where we go, Mary wants to be with you all the days of your life, all the places of your life. She wants to accompany you on the highway to heaven. Then she said, Estás en el hueco de mi regazo. Now, if you know Spanish, that's hard to translate. Any good translators here? The hueco would be the hueco de mi regazo would be the opening of my apron, right? And really what she's saying is, you are in my womb. What is the most intimate relationship between two persons on a human level? Human level? The baby in the womb of the mother? That's the most intimate relationship, where the mother is forming that baby within her womb, giving the baby blood and nutrients. So St. Louis de Montfort says this too, that we have to go into the womb of Mary. So all of this, as we celebrate the Immaculate Heart of Mary, we want to find refuge in the womb of Mary. And what is she going to do? She's going to form us to be another Jesus, so that we can say, it's no longer I who live, but it's God, it's Jesus who lives in us. So my prayer for the priest, my brother priest, as well as all of you, that you'll experience how much the hearts of Jesus and Mary love you, so you can give this love of Jesus and Mary to the whole world. So may God bless all of you today. Amen. To God the Father Almighty, dear brothers and sisters, may every prayer of our heart be directed. For His will it is that all humanity should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. After every prayer, we'll respond, Grant this, Almighty God. For the Holy Church of God, that the Lord may graciously watch over her and care for her, let us pray to the Lord. For the peoples of all the world, that the Lord may graciously preserve harmony among them, let us pray to the Lord. For all who are oppressed by any kind of need, that the Lord may graciously grant them relief, let us pray to the Lord. For ourselves and our own community, that the Lord may graciously receive us as a sacrifice acceptable to Himself, let us pray to the Lord. I'd like to pray in a special way for Father Barry. He's celebrating his 60th anniversary in a few days, that God would give him a lot of peace, a lot of joy, long life and eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord. And I'd like to pray for our fellow priests, that God would fill them with the love of the heart of Jesus and Mary, so they'd be able to give this love to the people they're serving. Let us pray to the Lord. And that all of us would also give the love of Jesus and Mary to the whole world. Let us pray to the Lord. Let's pray for all the people that are suffering in our parishes, loneliness, isolation, cancer treatment, fears, that God would console them in the heart of Jesus and Mary. Let us pray to the Lord.
O
God, our refuge and our strength, hear the prayers of your church. View yourself as the source of all devotion. Grant, we pray, that what we ask in faith, we may truly obtain through Christ our Lord.
Amen. I'm going to take lectures right now so you can sit down.
Thank you. Pray, brethren, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, O Lord, upon the prayers and offerings of your faithful, presented in commemoration of Blessed Mary, the Mother of God, that they may be pleasing to you, and may confer on us your help and forgiveness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever-Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voice, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Oh, Hosanna,
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Eucharistic prayer number 2. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. Okay. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. Body Christ. Body Christ. body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
So before giving the final blessing in honor of Mary, I'd like to thank all of you participating in this retreat and for the my fellow priests, celebrating in honor of Mary, and I'd like to reiterate my intention that we would honestly experience how much the Sacred Heart of Jesus loves us and how much Mary loves us so that we can give this love to the whole world. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God. Bow your heads and ask for God's blessing through the intercession of Mary, responding Amen after every blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of her through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life. Amen.
Amen.
May you who have devoutly gathered on this day carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down in you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
I want to thank all of our priests. I want to thank you, Father Groom, for joining us this year, Father John Sachenko, Father Mike Berry, but also all of you who came and heard confessions, and all of my the beloved priests of the Sacred Hearts who are joining us tonight for Mass. Thank you so much. And I understand that there were a lot of people in line for confession when Mass started. The priests are offered to go back outside, some of them, and hear your confessions. So if you want to go back in line after next, please do so.
Glory proclaim.